Hikaru Nakamura, ready for the new In Chess Classic final. Huge congratulations, Hikaru.
Thank you, guys. Appreciate it. It was quite dramatic.
That was quite dramatic. What a day. Have you enjoyed this, or has this been nerve-wracking?
I mean, I think actually that sort of sums up the match today, certainly. I felt that I was way too nervous in the first two games specifically. I never should have lost this first game. In the second game, I probably was doing well. So my nerves really failed me, I thought, in those first two games. But, you know, in the Blitz, I played well. And then the Armageddon game, I think Shaq maybe was a little bit better, but it was a very tricky position. He spent a lot of his time trying to find some sort of setup, and he wasn't able to. And then you know, I was just up a pawn, and I thought the Armageddon game was smooth. So it was definitely very nerve-wracking, but I felt pretty confident throughout.
And how did you recover your nerves after you lost three straight games?
I mean, I think the good thing is it's Blitz. You don't have a lot of time to think, so your mind can't really wander as much. I think that's... that certainly helped quite a bit, but mainly it's just that, you know, I felt that I played really bad chess, I thought. I mean, I made a lot of mistakes in the first two games that I didn't feel were characteristic, and then the third game also wasn't really that wonderful. So sort of I had the mindset that I couldn't play much worse than I did in the first three games, and I was just much more solid, I felt. And, you know, if I had played badly throughout, that's life, but I always felt that, you know, if we got to the Blitz, I should be able to pull it together. Mm.
And Hikaru, you mentioned the Armageddon. You felt it was smooth. Do you have any tips for the viewers at home on how to handle nerves in these really high-pressure situations?
Yeah, so actually, no, I said it was smooth, but I did allow him to get the sacrifice that I never should have let him get, to be fair. And Shaq did go for it correctly. You know, I think the thing is, in Armageddon, you really need to just blitz out those first 15 to 20 moves. If you get those first 15 to 20 moves, I think you're always going to be in good shape. So you have to be careful, but try to play openings that allow that. And actually, you know, I was thinking the one time that I did lose in an Armageddon game where I had the choice of color and I picked black was to Danil Dubov in that final. I forget which event it was last year, one of the events at any rate. And I did not get out of the opening in that game with a good position. It was like around move 8 or 9, and it got very complicated right away. So I think if you're playing black, you want to see if you can play some sort of basic opening setup, get the first 20 moves. If you're white, it's the exact opposite. You want to try and create complications from move 1, basically.
Mm. Were you ever tempted to take white, or was you always going to choose black in that Armageddon?
You know, it's funny because I found some ways to lose these games in the Nimso Indians. So I did very briefly consider it. But again, I think at the end of the day, I am generally faster than Shaq Rear and Blitz. So that played a big role. But then secondly, I mean, you know, 65-70% of games are going to be a draw naturally. And so I think you just have to play the odds. And those two factors certainly made my decision a lot easier. But I would be lying if I didn't say that I briefly considered picking white.
So Hikaru, are you as excited as we and all the fans are, not only that you are in the final, but that we will have a final with yourself and Magnus Carlsen?
Yeah, I mean, I think I'll get excited about it in like 20, 30 minutes after I've gotten over this. Because, I mean, the thing is that it wasn't a situation where I really was in this match. Like in the first game, it was very tense till the end, and then I lost that. And then I lost the second game relatively quickly. Maybe not quickly, but I lost that second game. So I was basically in my own world, kind of focusing on my match and not really thinking about anything else. Until now, basically. But yeah, I think it's always fun it's fun having the opportunity to play Magnus again. I think for both of us, somebody's going to win this match and have a sort of a redeeming result, because I think for both of us, it's been a while since I can't even remember the last time Magnus was in a final, actually, of one of these events. So it's like, I think for both of us, we have a chance to redeem ourselves. And it's always fun to play Magnus. I mean, even if he's had bad results, he still is the world champion. And yeah, I'm just looking forward to it. Mm.
Of course, you have faced him quite a lot of times, also in a final last year. So sort of what is the recipe for you? How do you prepare? And what is sort of the recipe to beat Magnus?
I think just try to play good chess, basically. And, you know, if you play good chess, generally good things will happen. I would also say that it felt like at times in his match against Levin, I only speak from yesterday because today I didn't see anything, but Magnus was ahead and then he lost his last game to Levin. So, you know, there are always going to be opportunities again. But I think the main thing is if you just focus on playing good chess, don't worry about who the opponent is, then good things can happen. And I'll just take it, you know, one game at a time. But I think the good thing also is that You know, I've played Magnus so many times. I've looked at so much stuff already for the various other opponents that I've played that it's just going to be fun. Mm. And that's all I really have to say.
I agree.
Yeah, judging on your form, Hikaru, how would you rate those chances?
I mean, I think it's pretty simple. If I keep my nerves together, I think I have reasonable chances. If I play the way that I did, either tomorrow or the second day, like I played in the first game or the first two games today, I have no chance. I mean, just very, very simple.
All right, Hikaru, we wish you the best of luck in the final.
Thank you, you guys.
Thanks
you guys
so much
tomorrow.
For joining us. See you tomorrow.